Thank you for joining this video about FACET, a new dataset created by Meta AI in order to evaluate a benchmark for fairness of computer vision models. Computer vision models are known to have biases that can impact their performance. For example, given an image classification model, if we feed it with an image of a male soccer player, the model is likely to classify that image as a soccer player. However, if we introduce the model with a female soccer player, the model is more likely to be confused and may not classify the image correctly. This is just an example for what fairness means, and later on we'll see real examples that FACET dataset helps to find. The FACET dataset was presented in a research paper titled FACET, Fairness in Computer Vision Evaluation Benchmark, and in this video we'll explain the research paper to understand what kind of data this dataset has, what we can do with that, and how it was created. Let's start by exploring what kind of data we have in the FACET dataset. Here is one example of an image of a singer. We can see that there is a box around the singer in the image, which means we can use the dataset for object detection evaluation. And zooming in, we can see few more annotations, such as the class of the image, which is a singer, the gender, which is male, a skin tone, which here we see mostly light skin colors as the annotation, age group, provided as middle age, hair color, which is black, hair type, which is missing in this case, lightning, and which part is visible. Another example to get a feeling of this is this image of a basketball player, where again we see that the person location in the image is annotated with a box, and the same annotations as before. More of them are missing for this example, as we can see with the undetermined value. If you'd like to explore more images in the dataset, you can do so in the Dataset Explorer available on the Meta Demo Lab website. In the following table from the paper, we can see that the dataset contains 32K images and 50K people. So, there are images with more than one person in them. Each person is annotated with a class, such as the singer and the basketball player we just saw, which can be used to evaluate image classification models. Each person is also surrounded with a bounding box, which can be used for object detection evaluation. The dataset also has 69K masks labeled as person, air, or clothing, which can be used to evaluate image segmentation models. As we saw in the two image examples, there are also annotations for skin tone, age group, and gender, which can be used to check disparity for certain protected groups, and there are various more attributes, such as hair details, face masks, tattoo, and lightning. Another table from the paper, which we see now, shows a breakdown of representation of the demographic groups in the dataset. Under the gender statistics, we see that the majority of the persons and images are related to males. The skin tone seems to look quite as a normal distribution, where there seems to be higher representation for lighter skin in levels 2 to 5 or 6. For the age group, we see that the majority of persons are classified as middle age, and low number of persons are classified as old. Let's move on to see how the FACET dataset was created. First, the researchers created person-related categories, where they start from all children of the person world in WordNet, which is a hierarchical database of language concepts. For example, here we see the tree structure in WordNet for two of the final categories, judge and referee. The categories are filtered based on overlapping with ImageNet classes. Since many models are trained on ImageNet and on other datasets with classes similar to ImageNet, this step helps to make the dataset a good fit for evaluation for such models. After few more filtering steps, such as removing categories with low number of samples and more, we get the final 52 categories. Then, to create a dataset of images, the researchers start from 1 billion images from the Segment Anything 1B dataset. This set is filtered to images where captions or tags of the image in the Segment Anything dataset are related to the chosen 52 categories. The first step is an automatic pre-processing. Then there is another filtering step by categories, this time using human annotators. Then we get the 32K of images to annotate. Then, after a few annotation stages, we get the FACET dataset, where the annotation stages are all done by humans. And they include first creating the bounding boxes and labeling each box from one of the 52 categories. Then there is a dedicated step to annotate the skin tone, where the annotations are aggregated from multiple annotators, since they can be impacted from the annotator's skin tone. Then all other attributes are being annotated. And the last step is labeling the masks for object segmentation, where the masks are available since the images are taken from the Segment Anything dataset. To increase the diversity of the annotations, the annotators are selected from diverse locations, as we can see in this chart from the paper. Before moving on, if you like this content, then please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. Let's now take a look at some of the results from the paper. Starting from image classification, where the researchers calculated recall from Clip, which is an image and text model from OpenAI that can be used for zero-shot image classification. The recall was calculated for each of the categories, for male and female labels, and in the following table we can see the categories where the diff in performance is the most significant. An interesting observation here is that Clip did a much better job, more than 20% better, of classifying a dancer class for female dancers comparing to male dancers. Another interesting disparity is better performance for female nurse, being more than 10% better. On the left side we see that Clip did a better job classifying male gardeners and male laborers. Another interesting result in the paper is for object detection task, where they try to answer whether a standard detection model struggles to detect people whose skin appear darker. As a standard detection model, the researcher take a faster RCNN model that was pre-trained on the COCO dataset. And in the following table we see the average recall of detecting a person based on its skin tone, where the three columns represent different IOU values for the detected box comparing to the labeled box, and it is clear from the results that the model performed better for lighter skin tone comparing to darker skin tone. Given the diverse set of annotations, many interesting questions such as this can be explored using the FACET model. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next video.